Endoscopy makes up a large part of a gastroenterologist's clinical practice, with the average gastroenterologist performing nearly 35 procedures per week. The performance of endoscopy places unique strains upon the body. These include forces on the forearms, wrists, and thumbs during torque of the insertion tube and adjustment of the dials, and neck and back pain from peering at monitors and twisting to manipulate the scope. Upper extremity and back injuries are common among endoscopists. In a survey of 237 gastroenterologists, 78% reported injuries and 85% reported pain during procedures, particularly when applying torque to the insertion tube and turning the scope dials. We can use the principles of ergonomics to guide us to prevent these injuries. The main determinants of upper body posture during endoscopy are patient, endoscopy equipment, and monitor position. Monitors should be directly in front of the endoscopist to avoid rotation of the cervical spine. This has been studied in the laparoscopic literature, and it's reasonable to presume it applies to GI endoscopy as well. By optimizing monitor placement, we may reduce chronic neck pain. For a 14-inch screen, the optimal distance of the monitor from the endoscopist to reduce eye strain is between 90 to 182 centimeters, although this may vary depending on the size of the screen. Endoscopists come in all sizes, so your monitor height should be adjustable. The endoscopist should adjust both the bed and the monitor to optimal heights before performing endoscopy. Monitor height should be at 20 centimeters below the height of the endoscopist, which places the center of the image at approximately 10 degrees below the horizon to minimize neck flexion and maintain the natural curve of the cervical spine to reduce neck strain of the endoscopist. Optimal bed height is between elbow height and 10 centimeters below elbow height. This allows for shoulder and arm relaxation and minimizes endoscopist fatigue. Other suggestions include making sure there are recovery times between colonoscopies, which can be used to write endoscopy notes, and cushioned washable mats allow for slight instability of the legs, leading to subtle movements of the legs and increased blood flow to reduce foot and leg injuries. We also encourage using an athletic stance during endoscopy, shoulders back, chest out, knees bent, and feet hip-width apart. These help prevent the pelvic girdle twisting and turning that may lead to awkward positions and instead leaves the endoscopist in a neutral position for the procedure. The use of torque is a necessary part of successful colonoscopy. Studies assessing the force of the right hand applies during the scope insertion have shown that during scope reduction and maneuvering through the sigmoid colon, torque forces and forces applied against the wall of the colon are highest. When of sufficient magnitude and duration, these forces are associated with an increased risk of thumb and wrist injuries. We encourage endoscopists to keep the scope in the most neutral position possible and to reduce overuse of torque and the forces on the wrists and thumbs. When possible, lead aprons for procedures that require fluoroscopy should be two-piece aprons, which transfer some of the weight of the apron from the shoulders to the hips and reduce upper body strain. Optimizing the room for these procedures is even more important given the extra weight of the lead on the body and the multiple screens often used for the procedure. While many transformations must take place in your development as an endoscopist, it is not necessary that you transform yourself into the scope. Personification, or quote, becoming the scope, is subconsciously used to coax the scope into going where you want. And this is a common phenomenon during training. While this is a positive cognitive sign, it can lead to holding awkward positions which have no positive effect on procedural outcome. Your staff will likely notice and correct these postures, but foreknowledge of them will hopefully help you recognize and modify them too. We also suggest some preventative exercises of the upper extremities to reduce pain and injuries. Reach your arm in front of the body and the palm facing away from you, fingers facing down. Starting with your little finger, massage each finger from the base to the tip, holding each fingertip toward your chest for 10 seconds of gentle stretch. Do this with both hands. Reach your right hand in front of you with fingers up and pull all four fingertips back towards your chest with your left hand. Hold this for 10 seconds and then switch hands. Repeat with the right hand with fingers pointing down. Make a soft fist with each hand and roll the wrist in circles 10 times in each direction. Then bring the inner wrist together with fingertips gently touching each other. Roll the inner hands into outer hands, creating a circle to and away from your body. Interlace your fingers and stretch your arms out in front of you with palms facing away. Hold the position for 20 seconds and then reach over your head, keeping the fingers interlaced. Pull your arms back while pressing your shoulders down. Roll the shoulder forward and up. Hold there for a moment, and then slide shoulders back and down. Repeat 5 times, and then again 5 times in the opposite direction. Place both hands on a desk, palms down, with fingers pointing toward you. Keep the base of the palms down on the desk and bend your elbows in toward the body. Adjust the weight of your body back onto your heels and hold for 30 seconds. We hope that this video has helped you optimize your endoscopy environment to reduce or prevent chronic pain and injuries and make endoscopy more comfortable. We also hope that the exercises we have described will help prevent overuse injuries.